गुड मॉर्निंग। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग इंटेलिजेंस एंड इमोशन। फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग इंटेलिजेंस। वन पर्सन कैन सॉल्व ए प्रॉब्लम वेरी वेल बट अनदर मे सॉल्व वेरी पोअरली। दीज आर ड्यू टू डिफरेंट एबिलिटीज लाई विद इन देम। No doubt, interest, attitude, knowledge, and similar other attributes count towards such performances. But still, there is left something apart from these attributes that weigh more. This latter attribute is termed by psychologists as intelligence. Intelligence referred to the ability to learn readily and accurately, to comprehend properly, and to solve a problem purposefully. Intelligence depends upon cerebral cortex. The increase in intelligence does not depend upon the large number of brain cells in the cortex. It depends upon their larger size and complexity. Greater number of convolutions, the greater is the intelligence. Apart from intelligence, the cerebral cortex is responsible for other intellectual functions like planning, judgment, etc. Intelligence depends on the ability to receive, respond, and adapt. These intellectual activities are determined by memory of all past impressions received through all sensory organs. By associative faculties, these sensory impressions are synthesized into various complex patterns and are stored as memory. Whenever a new impression comes, its full significance is understood. By analyzing it in the background of this memory, and an appropriate response is organized accordingly. Intelligence development is primarily innate, but in some cases may be due to both heredity and environment. Intelligence finds its expression in good environment. For example, a child with a rural environment gets a more stimulating environment in a town that gives better opportunity for the expression of his intelligence. Intelligence of a person is determined by intelligence quotient or IQ. It is measured by dividing one's mental age by his chronological or actual age. Thus, IQ is equal to MA divided by CA into 100. Among normal persons, some are deficient in intelligence who cannot manage their own lives. They are termed as idiots, imbeciles, and morons. Idiots are the most deficient in intelligence. They cannot attend their bodily needs. They cannot learn to eat or drink, to wash or dress themselves. They cannot talk beyond few monosyllables. They cannot avoid common dangers of life like fire, etc. Their IQ is 1 to 19. Imbeciles are less defective than idiots. They are able to avoid common danger of life, but they cannot learn to do much useful work. Some of them can eat, wash, dress themselves. Their IQ belong 20 to 29. Morons are less defective than imbeciles, having IQ 40 to 70. They can take care of animals and others. Idiots and imbeciles are normal except for some early damage to the brain, as by birth or injury. There is usually no pathology in morons. They are normal individuals with least intelligence. Now we will discuss about emotion. A person looks at a rose or red color. It gives him pleasure. He hears a noise. It gives him pain. These are simple sense feeling. A student after getting high success in the examination feels joy. A person may have a pain from grief. The pleasantness of the rose or the pain from noise are feelings, while the joy of success or pain from grief is emotions. The most obvious place of emotional expression is the face. Of course, we do not always display over emotions on our faces. We can grieve and feel enormously sad without weeping. Thus, we use facial expression to lie about our feelings as well as to express them. These facial expressions are the objective symptoms which possesses high rank value in homeopathic prescription. Emotion is a complex affective experience expressed in characteristic behavior patterns. Emotions are universal. They are centrally excited. They differ from individual to individual. Emotions arise abruptly and subside slowly. An emotion causes many physical or physiological changes. An emotion has an affective quality. It ends either in pleasure or in pain. Same emotion may be experienced from different stimuli. Coming of tears may be from a joy or from a grief. Now, physiology of emotion. Recently, researchers have focused on a small structure in limbic system named amygdala that is involved with emotional expressions. It responds for initial decision to approach or withdraw from a person or situation. The amygdala quickly assesses a danger or threat, which is a good thing for the safety of the individual. The two central hemispheres play a great role in emotion. The left hemisphere is associated with positive emotions as happiness, whereas right hemisphere is involved in negative emotions as fear and sadness. Damage to the left hemisphere tends to produce excessive anger or depression, and damage to the right hemisphere causes mania and laughing. The brain has a variety of chemical messengers at its disposal, namely neurotransmitters, hormones, and neuromodulators, which play a great role in emotions. Neurotransmitters act on specific nerve circuits and thus affect mood, memory, and well-being. Hormones, particularly epinephrine and norepinephrine, activate the sympathetic branch of the autonomic nervous system and thus produce a state of arousal, a level of alertness that allows the body to respond quickly. During this arousal, the pupil dilate, widening to allow in more light, the heart beats faster, breathing speeds up, blood sugar rises, providing the body with more energy to act, and digestion slows down, so that blood flow can be diverted from the stomach and intestines to the muscles and surface of the skin. This is why when you are excited, scared, furious, or wildly in love, you may not want to eat. In addition, your memory, concentration, and performance improved up to a point If hormone levels become too high, concentration and performances worsen. This is why a little nervousness when you take an examination is a good thing, but hand trembling anxiety is not. Epinephrine in particular provides the energy of an emotion. Neuromodulators increase or decrease the actions of a specific neurotransmitters and thus play role in emotion. Classification. According to origin, they are classified into primary, secondary, and derived emotions. There are 7 basic or primary emotions like anger, fear, happiness, surprise, disgust, sadness, and contempt. The combination of 2 primary emotions is secondary emotion like awe, which is the combination of surprise and fear. Anxiety, confidence, hope, etc. are derived emotions. According to result, emotions are pleasant or positive and unpleasant or negative. Love, joy, happiness, etc. are positive emotions. They are helpful and essential to normal development, but fear, jealousy, anger, etc. are negative emotions as they are harmful to the individual. There are various emotional abnormalities like depression, mania, apathy, and melancholia. Depression is the most common form of abnormalities. In it, the person feels miserable and unhappy. Feeling of sadness is the characteristic of depression. We find depression usually under the miasm, syphilis, and medicine like lachesis, where there are hopeless, helpless, and tiredness of mind. In mania, the person displays an abnormal output of energy. He is constantly active. He takes upon one occupation, gives it up immediately, and commences other. These are found under the miasm Sura. In mania of Sura, there is no end to his words. Words are multiplied and he has no trouble in finding them. His thoughts run so fast and words are so multiplied that he does not know what to do with them. And in medicines like all this sulfur, we have such type of symptoms. In apathy, the person does not take any interest in the environment. He is neither excited nor depressed, but absolutely indifferent. Melancholia is a condition characterized by marked feeling of unworthiness and sin mixed with sadness. So in nutshell, we have discussed regarding emotion and intelligence. Today, up to this, thank you all.